the maker and knowledge of that, the film I Can Never Make. I think I would like to start with talking about hope in Cannes Festival, where this film very deservingly won the big award. Second time. You were talking about the feeling of shock, of being 50 years into your career, making a film about similar social situations and conditions that you've dealt with from the very beginning. And I wanted to ask you about the flip side of it, about hope, about making films on these issues for 50 years and still showing rays of light, showing some hope in relationships between people, and people keeping their self-dignity, and people being able to do good, even if limited by the system.
Yes, well, this day of all days, we've got to look pretty closely for some hope, haven't we, after the news from the United States, which is pretty devastating, I think, for a lot of people. It's not a direct answer to your question, but I think our initial thoughts are for all the people who will be very afraid now by having this man there. Because a lot of people are going to be under a lot of pressure in the States, and people will be very fearful. So I think that the first thought isn't of hope, it's just for sympathy for solidarity with all the people that he's attacked. And will now be very fearful. But yeah, there's always hope. I mean, history is dynamic. It's not fixed. We haven't reached the end of the story yet. So the hope is in the fact that people will resist, and while the state will behave with cruelty as neighbours. We still show solidarity and we still show mutual support and kindness. And when we went to the food banks and met people there, and they were the most generous people. And there was one line that we noticed that people said when people went to get, desperate people went to get food from the charity. They didn't say, let us help you to your free bag of food. They said, let us help you do your shopping. I think that's such generosity of spirit, really, that's the hope. But it doesn't mean anything unless it translates to political action, because it's no use us feeling sorrow and feeling mutual support unless we take political action. And it depends what people do when they leave the cinema, to be honest. Really. And if people get organised, yes, there's hope. If we just sit and feel sorry for ourselves, we ain't got much.
And there's also hope in the cinema, from how you talk about it. You know what the cinema can do, what the cinema can show, connect to people, and again, cinema quite a different place from its point in the 1960s. Still different in addressing these kind of issues, or in invested in cinema and what it may do.
Cinema's okay. it's a wonderful medium. It's a wonderful medium for telling stories of how life is, and for exchanging our ideas and fantasies and jokes and comedy and imagination and all that. It's a wonderful medium, and it's why we need festivals like this, and we need support, you know, for independent cinema, because if we leave it to the market. It's very difficult to survive, and I've been very lucky, and the group I work with have been very lucky in that we've found a little corner where we can operate in European cinema, and there are a few people you know, with the same good fortune. But there are many, many fine people who would be fine filmmakers who just don't get the commissions. So independent cinema could be brilliant, but it just needs more support. It needs more screens, it needs more commissions, and it needs to develop a relationship with the audience. Because if you don't develop a relationship with the audience, you can't become a good filmmaker. You need to have that connection. But yes, it's still good.
And this film was made on 35mm, or still on 35mm.
Absolutely, yes.
Less and less.
Yes.
Sometimes we see it strictly nostalgic or special effects uses. Your scene's different.
No, I think it's... we all much prefer celluloid. It gives you a different image. You can only shoot it in 10-minute reels, so you have to be much more disciplined about how you arrange the shots. And we would cut on film, but the infrastructure's gone now. So we had to cut on digitally, which was a great grief to us. Celluloid is... It's a different image, really, but... I mean, it's like oil paint and watercolour, I think. You get a different texture. We had to cut on a computer, sadly.
A little bit more about the making of the film, specifically the working with the performers, with the actors, and a mix of professional and non-professional actors, and some come from very interesting backgrounds into the roles they got in this picture.
It was a mixture of people doing what they do in real life. The people working in the job centre, apart from the two main parts, the people working in the job centre had worked in job centres, and they'd left in disgust at what they were being asked to do. And the people who were in the food banks operate that food bank. So we stayed as close to reality as we could. David Johns, who plays Daniel Blake, is a stand-up comic. He began life as a bricklayer, and he's from Newcastle. He's actually from the very streets where we did the filming. So he knows it. He doesn't have to do sociology to understand the situation. He knows it from his own family. So we just tried to stick to as close to the reality as possible. Really. But we should maybe see what people...
Absolutely. I want to invite both questions from the audience and, as Mr. Lott mentioned in the beginning, comments, and then maybe people can share their own experience and thought on the work.
And could I say to the electricians, if there's any way of dimming the spot so that we can see each other, that would be great. Okay, fantastic. Thank you.
We have two questions, one here and one in the front. Let's